Hello everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you there is another exploit name called Hive Nightmare. And in this exploit so far I didn't find any patch, and today is the date of 21st July, and you can see that timeanddate.com. This exploit will lead you to local privilege escalations, but need little bit of information that how we can use this exploit and how we can leverage in which cases. So one of the prerequisite is that you should have your restore point enabled. If your restore point is not enabled, then this exploit is not going to work. So let's jump into the machine and try to understand how can we use this exploit in our test environment. So what I'm going to do, I'm logged in a user called CS99. We will see what kind of privileges we have for this user. And for that, we are using net user CS99 command. Let me maximize this so that you can see all the things. So it is a normal user, local group, membership. There is no global membership for this users. So I will be using this that CS99 to as a normal user for this exploit, and then we will be migrating to other user, which is, let's see what other users are there. So we will be migrating to administrator user, which is here admin, by using this vulnerability. That's the objective of this this demo. So let's do it. So in order to do this, we need the exploit. And if you go to the Hive, this GitHub repository, they have already compiled exploit for you. If you don't want to download that exploit, you can download this CSS file and you can do it. But I am using the already one which they have actually made it available for this. So here it in the release, you see this hivenightmare.exe. I already advise you that don't do it in the production. You don't know what is this exe it is. So it's always recommended that you should compile and do it. But for this testing environment, I just downloaded this exploit or exe. And in order to work with this exe, you just go to that directory where it is. Okay, here it is. And you can see in the corner, I'm logged in as a normal user PowerShell. It's no need for having something with a privilege, PowerShell or something. You just need a normal user PowerShell. Logged in over there. Just click dot backward slash and type Hive and just press enter. It will do work for you. You see that same have written output in the current working directory. If you look again for dir. So it will create it three files for you. One is SAM file, another one is system file, and third one, the second one is security, and third one is system file. So these three files has been created. You just need to copy these files to the location and your Kali machines. So I will be copying this to the Kali and we'll see you there. All right, now I have copied these three files to my Kali machines. As you can see, it is in the desktop. And now I will be leveraging the psexec, commands. And that is the psexec and secret dumps command. Those are used to fetch the hashes from this. And that is the part of MPacket utility. If you don't know, just Google it into, from the GitHub, you can download this and use these commands. The first command in this direction will be secret dump, and let's see what are the options are there in the secret dumps. And from that perspective, you need the three files. One is the system, another one is the security, and third one is SAM. So we have all these three files, and make sure there is another command which you need to remember. In this case is local or the remote. You will be specifying the target and the IP address, and it will be the local in my case because I have already downloaded these three files. So let's use this command again and type this hyphen security and use this use this SEM file, which is in the right lead in the desktop. And sorry, security file. And another one will be the system file. And third one is the SEM file. And also there is a command, you call it the local, because all these files are residing on my local system. So just press enter and let's see how it goes. You can see that now we have the hashes and SEM file has getting dumped here, LM hashes and anti hash. So here is the hashes for administrator, this is the one which is for admin, and this is the one for, you can see, CS99, which we I am logged in. So I will be using these hashes to log into this machine using administrative privileges. So I will be copying this hash from here and using the another utility which is called psexec. So here it is, the psexec, and you can specify the hashes which I have copied here and the username which is admin. The IP address is in my case 162.192.168.0.165, and what I am looking for, cmd.exe. Okay, and once you specified all of this, just press enter. You will get a command prompt just to verify what kind of privileges you got it. Who am I using the command? You are antisystems. Just verify that. What is the IP address? And what else? Net user admin. You are logged in as an admin. So you are now a user of administrator and Docker, you know, group. So you can do whatever you want. Let's jump into the machine itself and let's see some of the key things which is required to run this. So here in the machine, now we can also verify net users admin. It is the part of the administrator groups and the Docker users group. And also we can, for this, I have already configured the prerequisite. In order to check the prerequisite, you need to just checkpoint, which is called checkpoint. I should not say checkpoint, it will be restoration point, I think, I forgot the name. Yeah, restore point. Yeah, here it is. So that required administrative privileges. So make sure that you have configured this, because without configuring this, this exploit is not going to work. So here it is. I have created this system protection, which is like a VSS file for the shadowing. If you want to remove it, just remove it. If this is not enabled, then this exploit is not going to work. Now I'm going to disable this, apply this. Okay, let's try to use the same exploit which we before to using this, I will be deleting all of these three files. Okay, now I have deleted. I will be using the same exploit. Let's see how it goes. It says that cannot open the SAM. And this exploit, it didn't work. However, it will be creating a file, but the size, you can see the 0KB. It shows that this is the one of the prerequisites that needed to run this exploit. And if you read about this over the blog here, they are also mentioning that you should have enabled the system protection for this exploit to work. What exactly it is doing, it's collecting the same system and security files from your machine, and these files you can dump using the secret dump command by leveraging the empower utility, and that empower utility will give you the hashes, LM hashes and anti LM hashes, and these hashes you can use to log into the with the administrative credentials. That's it is doing. So if you are interested to read about more about this, then you can go through with these articles which is mentioned here, and also I can paste the links. And so far we don't have any update from the Microsoft on this, but some you know users, they recommend the ACL configuration in this point of view and the EDR to look into the SEM file access being accessed, but I'm not sure which one is proactive and which one is you know effective, you know, countermeasure in this case or detection capabilities. But still I'm waiting for the Microsoft patch to release. Once it's released, I am going to patch it this vulnerability. Oh, hope you enjoyed this video. We'll catch you in the next video. Bye. Take care.